गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय 23rd लेक्चर्स ऑफ योर सब्जेक्ट कोर्स C701 एनवायरनमेंटल इंजीनियरिंग। वी आर स्टिल इन मॉड्यूल 6 ऑफ द मॉड्यूल नेम द वाटर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन। नाउ इन कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ माय 22nd लेक्चर, दैट इज द लास्ट लेक्चर ऑफ डिटरमिनेशन ऑफ द स्टोरेज रिजर्व टैंक, स्टिल विल बी डिस्कसिंग सम न्यूमेरिकल्स बिकॉज ओनली वन प्रॉब्लम वी हैव डिस्कस्ड टुडे। I will discuss the remaining problems that is related with the determination of the storage capacity reservoirs. Very, very important as per your syllabus is concerned in the distribution of storage reservoir. Now, one second problem I will discuss today. So the problem is that you have to find out the storage capacity to supply the demand. Shown in the following table, the inflow of water to the reservoir is maintained at a uniform rate throughout 24 hours. That is given in the question. Fine. So the 24 hours, it is given in 6 intervals, each of 4 hours, as you can see from the table. Okay. So now the demand is given also in the during that for each 4 hours, the demand is also given. So first, we have to calculate the total demand during the day. What is the total demand? Because if you sum up the this problem, sometimes it is different from that the earlier which I have described in my 22nd lecture the previous day. This sort of problem is some different nature from the earlier one. That's why I am discussing this problem today. Because first of all, we have to calculate the total demand during the day. So if we add the total demand of 24 hours, then we'll able to calculate the total demand during the day. So you will add up every demand, that there are 6 demands given in the tabulation forms. So after summation, it is coming 5.04 million liters, that is the demand during the day. Total supply during the day, that demand, because you have to what is the purpose of supply? To satisfy the demand. So that means if the demand is 5.04, that means this amount of water you have to supply so that to satisfy the demand. So total supply has to be 5.04 million per liters. And since it is given in the question, that is 24 hours, if the supply is throughout the, it is given in the question, maintained a uniform rate throughout 24 hours. That means that uniform rate, you have to find out 5.04 divided by 24, that is 0.21 million liters per hour. But here the interval is given in 4 hours, so 4 hours what will be the supply, that is the 0.84. Now you just complete the table. Now first column shown the time interval, that is the 6 time intervals, each of 4 hours duration, 0 to 4, 4 to 8, 8 to 12, 12 to 16, 16 to 12, and last one is 20 to 24. Now the demand in million liters is, it is given in the question, that is given in the question 0.48. 0.87, like these things, which is given in the question. This much amount of water is required. Then you have to calculate the cumulative demand. That means 0.48, then 0.48 plus 0.87, that is 1.35, then 1.35 plus 1.33, then 2.68. Like these things, you have to find out the cumulative demand in milliliter. Then you will come to the pumping part, that is the supply part, pumping in milliliter. What is the requirement? In 4 hours, we have found out 0.21 into 4, 0.84, this is the supply. So during these 4 hours each, the supply will be 0.84. Because this is a uniform supply throughout the 24 hours, so the same amount will be pumping. And the cumulative also pumping you have found out. Now you find out the 6th and 7th column, that is what is the excess of demand. And what is the excess of supply? Because ultimately, what is the aim of our determination? You have to find out the storage capacity, which is nothing but summation of the excess demand plus excess supply. So in first case, you see the supply is, cumulative supply is 0.84 and cumulative demand is 0.48. That means supply is excess of demand. So the 0.84 minus 0.48, that means the 0.36 is the, will go to the excess of supply part. Then the second part is the supply part is the 0.1.68 and demand is 1.35. cumulative demand is 1.35, cumulative demand is 1.68. So what is the excess of supply? There also, I think it is 0.33. So point, instead of 0.36, it will be 0.33. Now coming to the 8 to 12 hours, there the excess demand is 2.68 and supply is 2.52. So demand is excess, there is excess demand, 2.68 minus 2.52, that means 0.16. Likewise, 12 to 16 hours, if you see, the demand is 3.68, cumulative demand. Supply is 3.36. So there is excess of demand is 0.32. And last 16 to 12, excess of demand is 0.1. And 20 to 24 hours, the total demand equal to total supply. That has to be matched. That cumulative portion at the end, the demand has to be equal to the supply. That basis we have to find out the supply rate. So there is no excess of demand, excess of supply. Now, you have found out the excess of demand and excess of supply. Now you can find out the what is the excess of demand, what is the maximum value of excess of demand. Maximum value of excess of demand is corresponding to 12 to 16 hours, that is the 0.32. And maximum value of excess of supply is either 0 to 4 is 0.36. So here it is 0.36 and excess of demand is 0.32. So if you add excess of demand plus excess of supply, that is 0.68 milliliter is the 0.68 million liter. That means the 6,82,000 liters is the total storage required for that tank. So this is one solution I have done with a typical problem where the demand is given. And what we have done, we have equated total demand equal to total supply. Then we have calculated the supply rate and we have calculated the cumulative demand, cumulative supply, and excess demand, excess supply, and addition of the excess demand plus excess supply will give you the total storage requirement of the tank. Fine. Next, the example 16.3rd problem I am going to describe. Now, a town has a population of 1 lakhs. Now, it is to be supplied with the water at a rate of 200 liters per head per day. The variation in demand is as follows. Here I am telling the total population of the town is given, that is 1 lakhs, and it is supplied with the water at a rate of 200 liters per head per day. The variation in demand is as follows: 6 to 9, 40% of the total, 9 to 12, 10%. So the 100% demand, it is divided in various intervals, that is 6 to 9, 40, then 9 to 12, 10, 12 to 3, 10%, then 3 to 6, 15%, 6 to 9, 25%. So this is the demand, because demand fluctuated over the hours. So determine the capacity of the service reservoir when the pumping is at uniform rate from 6 to 6 p.m. That means 12 hours. So how to solve this problem? First of all, the total daily requirement is 1 lakhs into 1 lakhs is the population, it is given in the question, and the requirement of the water is 200 liters per head per day. So if you multiply 1 lakhs population into 200, you will get the 20 million liter, that is the total daily requirement of water. Okay, this is the requirement of the total water. That means this amount of water, it is a demand of the water, and this amount of water you have to supply. So the rate of demand of water, 6 to 9, it is given that 40% of the total. That means if it is 20 million liter is the total, then 6 to 9 period, the demand is 40% of the total million liter, that is 8. Similarly, 9 to AM, 9 AM to 12 AM, the 10% of the 20 milliliter demand, that means it is 2 ml. Likewise, 12 to 3, it is 2 ml. 3 to 6, it is 3 ml. 6 to 9, it is 5 ml. You add the demand 8 to 2, 3 plus 5, you will get 20 ml. So 20 ml total demand of the water, it is shown period 6 to 9, 9 to 12, 9 to 12 to 9, so that the summation will give you the total demand. Now demand in an individual period interval we have calculated, then the cumulative demand we have calculated. Fine. Now demand and supply lines have been drawn in firm and dotted line. This type of problem we are putting in a graphical representation to find out the solution, because we have to find out the ordinate, and from that we have to find out the solution, because the two higher ordinates, summation of the two higher ordinates value will give you the storage reservoir capacity. Now the demand and supply lines have to be drawn because the cumulative demand we have found out, and the supply also, the demand and supply lines have to be drawn in firm and dotted lines. That means demand will be in firm lines and supply will be in dotted lines. In figure, two maximum ordinates enclosed between the demand and supply have to be got. So you see, the supply lines is always a constant line, because at constant rate supply is given and the demand. So how do you draw the supply line? As it is given in the question, that total the variation in the, it is to be supplied with water at the rate of 200 liters per head per day. So the total water requirement 12 hours. That means uniform rate, this 12 million liter water you have to supply from 6 a.m. to 6 p.m. That means 12 hour. So the, what will be the supply rate? Supply rate is 20 divided by 12. 20 divided by 12. So this will be the supply rate. So that supply rate, that cumulative supply rate has been plotted as a straight line, that is a dotted, and the curve, it is shown as the demand curve. So what are the excess of supply ordinate? It is given as the maximum ordinate is 5 ml, 5 million liter. That is the maximum supply portion, that is the upper portion of the ordinate. And what is the demand portion, that is the bottom maximum ordinate, we are getting the 3 ml, that is the 3 million liter. The summation of this 3 plus 5, that is the 8 ml, will give you the total storage capacity of the tank. So this is the second problem I have described you. So this is the second problem I have described you. So so I must say about the there are the different types of tanks, I must say, but before that, the design consideration, here also some problems I must highlight. That is the one problem I must highlight. What a tank rate of pumping and this type of problem, I should show you the solution. Before that, I must say the solution. Let me, different problems have been discussed. Fine. Now, one problem I must discuss you now. That is the typical problem, because I just wish to show you the typical problems, not all problems, because if one typical problem I can show you, then you can solve the derived problems in association with the typical one. So let us discuss a typical problem. A water tank, that is the elevated tank, is to be provided for a town water supply, given the following data. So calculate the minimum capacity of the tank without any fire demand. Tank is empty between 12 to 15 hours. What is given? First of all, this problem is related with the overhead tank. Given the following data, calculating the minimum capacity of the tank without any fire demand. Tank is empty between 12 to 15 hours. So first of all, I have to find out the minimum capacity, and this has to be found out excluding the portion of the fire demand. And tank has to be empty between 12 to 15 hours. These data are given. You see, the different problems I am describing, not a typical same problem I am describing. So that you will have a fundamental understanding on the varieties of problems related with the storage capacity of reservoir. Now, the data given is the average water quality, that is 16,666 liters per hour. That is the average water supply. Fine. Rate of pumping, it is also given. Hours of pumping, how much arc of 14 to 12 and then 15 to 20, because 12 to 15, the tank is empty. So 15 to 20 against the hours of pumping is there. Fine. So to solve the problem, let me show you how to solve the problem. This problem I must discuss to you. It has to be solved analytically in the table given below. So as given in the question, you must remember that tank is empty between 12 and 15 hours. So this is the new thing, extra data I have put in the problem and making it an innovative one compared to the others two which you have described. Because there one clause is included, the tank is empty between 12 and 15 hours. And that is a special characteristics of this problem, particular problem which I am describing, that you have to remember. So we'll start from serial number 5, because 12 to 15 hours, okay, fine. Now let us see the first of all, 7 columns you have to prepare. One is the serial number, second column is the time, third column is the hours, fourth column is the water pumped, that is the supply portion. Fifth column is the water consumed, that is the demand portion. And accumulation of the draw, that is the 4 minus 5, that is the what is the supply and what is the consumed, that is the draw-off. And water service reservoir, water in service reservoir in liters. So first, 0 to 4 hours, that means in 4 hours, water pumped in, is there any 0 to 4 hours, is there any supply of water? Let me see. The problem which you have described, zero to 4 hours, that means, yes, water pump 0. That means no supply is there. You see, in the table, the question says that 0 to 4 hours, the water pump is 0. That means there is no supply. But water consumed 13,333. Okay. So what we can conclude in solving this problem, then coming to the solution part. So water pump, that means there no supply is there. So it is dash. Water consumed in liters 13,333, fine. Then the accumulation, that is the draw, supply is 0, demand is 13. So it is in negative supply, I can say. So accumulation is negative. That means what its significance? Its significance is negative, means it is the accumulation. There is a deficiency amount of the storage to meet the demand, that is minus 13,333. So water in service reservoir in liters. Water in service, first of all, I just want to say you the 6 column first, then I will describe the 7 column. So then again, if we describe the water pumped in liters, that is 4 to 6 hours. You see, 4 to 6 hours water pumped in liters, it is 50,000. And what is water consumed? Water consumed is 40,000. So you can write in the table, that 50,000 is the water pump, that is supply, So 40,000 water consumed. So plus 10,000, that means it is the accumulation of water in the reservoir. Next, if you see 6 to 10 hours, it is given in the question. 1 lakh water pumped and the water consumed more than the supply, that is the 1 lakh 20. So minus 20,000 is negative. Negative means it is shortage of supply. That much I can say. Now 10 to 12 hours. 10 to 12 hours. It is given in 13,333 is the water consumed, and supply is. Water pump supply is 50,000, and consumed is 33,000. So it is excess supply, that is 16,667. Now 12 to 15, that 3 hours water no supply is there because water is empty, tank is empty, no supply is there. That 3 hours, 12 to 15 hours, if you remember in the beginning of the question. But there is a demand of 25,000, so shortage of supply is minus 25,000. Now 15 to 16, the water pump, that is the supply, is 25,000. And water consumed is 8,333. Let me check 15 to 16. What is given in the question? Let me check just first. Yes, fine. 15 to 16, you see that water pumped supply is 25,000 and consumed is 8,333. So, yes, 15 to 16, 25,000, 8,333. So the excess in supply is 16,667. Similarly, 16 to 20, as given in question, water supply is 1 lakhs, demand is 1,06,000, so shortage is 6 lakhs. 20 to 23, supply is 75,000. Demand is 50,000, so 25,000 excess supply. Now 23 to 24, last interval, supply is zero, demand is at, so there is a shortage of supply, I must say. Now from column number 7, it is what I will describe. It is not clear that maximum balance storage is 35 liter. So now how you have to calculate the water in service reservoir in liters? Water in service reservoir in liters, how you have to calculate? Because here the accumulation of the water, that is given in the question, minus 13,000. And from how it can be considered that water in service or reservoir in liters, that is 18,334. So that I must tell you how it has been calculated, because 18,334. Fine. If you see the second column, then 10,000, then it is water in service reservoir in liters is 28,334. So that means how it can be calculated, that we must see. Fine. It is also given in the question, it is also given in the question that 12 to 15 hours the tank is empty. So at serial number 6, the serial number 6, the storage is 16,667. Against the serial number 7, it has reduced by 6,666. Hence, the storage is 16,666 minus 6,666 is 10,000. In 10,000. So again, I must tell you, is a very interesting thing which is to be noted, because in serial number 5, we see there is no supply because 12 to 5 the tank is empty. That means there is no supply. So if there is no supply, so at serial number 6, then what will happen? serial number 6, the storage is 16,666, what you have shown in the figure. Against serial number 6, that means at serial number 6, storage is plus 16,667, which you can see in serial number 6. Am I right? So, at serial number 7, it has reduced by 6,666. So, in serial number 7, if we have, it has reduced by 6,666. So, what will obtain? What will obtain that 16,667 and 6,667? So, balance 10,000 will be storage. Because there is no water from 12 to 15. So once it is established that 15 to 6, the accumulated 16,667 is a storage. So that means 6,667 already in negative. So ultimately the net storage is 10,000. Similarly, if we can see the 25,000, then we can, if we go for the 8, the if you see the accumulation draw off is 25,000, that is plus excess. So what will be the storage? 25,000 plus initial 10,000, that is 35,000. And what will be the in the 9, that is a deficiency in the storage. So that will be deducted. So after within 35,000, that 3,000 last one I am telling, 23 to 24 hours, that is 3,333 has to be deducted. And net storage is 31,67. So this is like this. Because initially the storage, likewise in 18,334, after that plus 10,000. So it has 10,000 plus 18,000, 28,000. Then 28,000 in serial number 3, the demand is minus 20,000. So it has become 8,334. So this is like this. So cumulative net figure, that is the net service reserve, that is the last column which has been put as a net storage capacity, net storage capacity which has been found out after deducting the accumulative value of the draw of figure, that is which we have got from column 4 minus column 5, that figure we have received. The last column which will give the water to service reservoir in liters, that is basically, I can say you, that is the net storage value which is given in the last column. Now, from column number 7, it is clear that maximum balance storage is 35,000. Because the what is the maximum balance, net balance is 35,000. So, minimum capacity of the tank should be 35,000 liter. So this is another way of solving the problem. I have shown you how to solve the problem of this type of category. So maximum balance storage should be the minimum capacity of the tank. And again, I can describe the SOQP problem. Another problem I can describe. This is one problem I have solution we have described. Okay. Then another problem I can describe. Fine. Suppose here the total daily requirements is given in 2 lakhs liter. Now the cumulative demand covered in tabulated in the table is given below. Suppose the 6 a.m. to 24 hours, that means today 6 a.m. to tomorrow 6 a.m. that means in 24 hours the in period 9 to 4, 4 to 7, 7 p.m. to 6 a.m. it is given the demand, and in 24 hours rate of demand it is given, because total demand, total water requirement 2 lakhs, and the breakable demand, that is the 30%, 35%, 25%, 10%, that is also given. So demand in liters as 2 lakhs, 30% is 60,000. So we have calculated the demands and the cumulative demand, and the mass curve we have plotted. That demand curve is the curve portion, and the straight line is the supply portion. What is the supply figure? Because supply 2 lakhs liter, has to be supplied in 24 hours. So per hour supply rate, we know, we can plot the curve. So then the maximum ordinate, the lower portion, that is when the demand is more than the supply, that is the excess demand I have calculated, that is all given by ordinate B, and ordinate A, which is given by the excess supply, that is when the supply is more than the demand, that value we have calculated. So as I've told you, the rate of supply in 10 hours, total demand is met in 10 hours. So total rate of supply we have calculated. So maximum ordinate A and B, if we add, so we'll get the storage capacity of 72,000 liters. So this is another problem I have shown you. Now another problem I am going to show you, so that you have a clear conception on this matter. Now the cumulative supply over demand, that is excess supply to the tank, is 1800 meter cube. That has been found out in the solution, so we can find out if it is excess supply, if it is found that the cumulative supply over demand, that is excess supply of the tank, is 1800, then you have to prepare the tank for that 1800 capacity only. So this is the solution of that type of problem I can show you. Can you see the demand from the clear water? It is given first in 2 meter cube, that is the, in terms of meter cube, it is given 0 to 4 nil, no demand. Then the demand, it is shown, then cumulative demand, we have shown this in the figure. Then the supply of the clear water in the tank, it is also given. Cumulative supply determined. So cumulative supply minus cumulative demand, that is the excess supply, I mean to say that, plus 800. Then second, 4 to 14 cumulative supply is 2800, cumulative demand is 1200, so excess supply is 1600. So then cumulative supply is 3000. So here, this is a problem I am going to give you the example, where there is no excess of demand. Everything is excess of supply. So only thing, there is no excess of demand. So excess of supply, so everywhere the excess of supply is there. So the maximum excess supply, which you have found out, that is 1800, that is the storage capacity. Because there is no question of excess of demand, so only one factor is there. So it might happen, there may not be the excess of demand. Excess of supply is there. Then the excess of supply criteria itself will be given the decision matter in capacity of the storage tank. So I hope the module 4, that is the 4 hours duration modules, that is initially we have taken the 2 classes, that is the 21st and 20th and 21st classes on the analysis part of the pipe distribution network by Hardy-Kasse method, and today I have described the 22nd and 23rd classes of the same module, module 6, water distribution, and I will complete the water distribution, that is the 6th model of your subject code C701, because 4 lectures, that is 21, 20, 21st, 22nd and 23, that 4 lectures I have deliberated on this topics module 6, that is the water distribution network. So I will close it a day, and before that I must again say that I will upload my video lecture, upload my video lectures in the Google Classroom. Kindly go through the Google Classroom, go to my lecture notes, and we will have an interaction session very soon in the live classroom. We will be meeting in the GoTo meeting or Zoom classroom. There the different questionnaires will be asked if any clarifications is required by the student. So students, thank you very much. Thank you all. So have a nice day.